The area I'd like to talk about is the end too big to fail. And those of you who followed Dodd-Frank know that we argued very vociferously on our side for an enhanced bankruptcy for failing institutions, for large institutions. Acknowledged that the bankruptcy code, it was as it presently written, was not written for these large systemically important institutions. But we really felt in order to make sure that the taxpayers were not going to be and could never be on the hook for another bailout, we really felt that bankruptcy brought that, an enhanced bankruptcy would bring that isolation and judicial overview that would ensure the taxpayers not on the hook. But what we have as a resolution authority created through the FDIC, and I think it's very questionable. We've had hearings that has said, number one, can the FDIC really handle this if there's more than one institution? In the president's own meeting that he had a month ago, several questions were raised to actually, would the process really be able to go forward, and would the FDIC really be able to handle this? The market participants and credit rating agencies still say that the backstop or the of the federal government still exists for these large institutions. If you go into a resolution, an enhanced or a resolution authority, it's written in the law that you can come to the Treasury and use taxpayers' dollars to unwind these institutions. And I think that just further inculcates and elongates the too big to fail, which was supposed to be one of the primary reasons that Dodd-Frank was created. So I think what we've got here is a situation where the taxpayers are still on the hook, where the larger institutions are getting larger, where the significant financial institutions are put in a category that has given them that aura of a federal backstop. And so for that, I've never heard of an F-, so I'm going to give a grade on ending too big to fail in terms of Dodd-Frank. As a mother, I can hardly even write an F. It pains me so much.